What is that? Oh, hi, Isaac. Is that enough, then?
Today, Miss Ellie?
Today is Easter Sunday. Christ has risen.
And what year is it?
This is 1997.
Yes.
This is March 30th?
March 30th.
All right.
And we're on vacation.
And we're on vacation here up at Ely, Minnesota, northern Minnesota, where the Canadian boundary waters are. And we're having a great time, and we wish all of y'all could be here.
Yeah.
Yes.
I don't know about all of you.
No?
Some of you. And we're so glad Isaac is here.
Yes.
Last time Isaac was here, he was 7 weeks old.
That's right.
It was 20 below zero.
Yes.
And 98 inches accumulated snow. A little bit warmer now. It's about 28 degrees.
What?
He's drinking his cup of coffee. Enough? You need a refill? Thank you.
And who's
Isaac
playing on the tape there?
It's our landlord.
I'm a groupie of Jim Croce. I'm going to be the president of his fan club when he makes it big. I told him that already.
Oh.
So he's got me lined up.
Hi, Isaac. Where's mommy? Where's mama?
That's more coffee.
I glance sometimes. See, I don't care where she is. I'm busy. Isaac, are you busy? Can you say hi to Grandma and Grandpa?
Grandma and Grandpa just got back from California. Travel across the United States.
Isaac.
Grandma Cohen spent a month out in California with their granddaughter, son.
Isaac.
Grandpa Cohen or Jamaica.
Mama telling you.
Cousins. Jamila.
That's all we're gonna get.
They're out there. They just got there yesterday.
Jamila and Luke. Oh, you're talking about Jamaica. I'm with you. I thought you were talking about Grandma and Grandpa Coin. Okay, bye you all.
Bye everybody.
Bye-bye.
Hi, sweetie.
Dan.
Hey, girl, how you doing? Fine. Still on our Easter vacation in Ely, Minnesota. And Isaac is preparing for a spit bath with Mom, although Mom's going to be clothed fully. And the famous spit bath area will probably be this area here. Or, oh, it's happening right there. I see, right on our rug. In front of God and everybody. While this is occurring, there is a woman watching over here, but she's reading something here. Oh. Growing up white? Daniel.
Daniel.
Oh, Isaac, yeah. They have Michael Bolton playing. Wonderful Easter. Easter evening, 1997, Ely, Minnesota. And you were there. Yeah, Isaac, Mama's going to take care of business. She's going to go visit that men's room. Here comes Mommy, Isaac. She looks much more relaxed. Yeah. She is one with the woods. What a wonderful mommy and wife we have there, Isaac. Though her choice of clothing, I don't know. It's a bit unusual. I don't see a lot of that in South Evanston. Maybe South Chicago, I don't know. Mommy's very wise. Hey, here comes Mommy. There's Mama, Isaac. There's Mama. Woman from the outdoors. Hey, wilderness woman.
I'm a new woman. Yes.
You look more relaxed.
Oh, yes. It's cold out there. All right, put your neck
tell us about it. Oh.
Traveling on the 1st of April. Country roads in the wilderness. Hopefully we'll spot some deer, maybe a moose. But as you can see, Isaac is thrilled. He's just can hardly contain himself on this adventure.
thank you for that wonderful hat that we got.
It's from the Iversons.
From the Iversons.
Hi, Isaac.
Good night, Isaac. We love you.
Night, night. Yep, he's out. What day is today, Dan?
You want to show the outdoors at all? Just to give you an idea. These are trees. This is tar of a road. Blue sky. It's April 1st.
1997.
Ely, Minnesota. I'm just going to go cruising while our friend Ellie Davis is back doing some homework for her college classes. We haven't had a bath for 4 days. Unfortunately, you can't smell us. But we're going to a sauna tomorrow. It opens about 2, 3 o'clock. We'll go in there and spend an hour each. We got shower, soap, shampoo. Real toilets.
Okay, over now. Roger. Am I recording? Is your red light on?
No.
Find them on my lens. There they are. Oh, where are they now? There they are. Which is, yeah.
How come I keep hearing that? Oh, now you're recording.
I don't know.
Now you're recording. You weren't before.
No, I don't know. There's two of them.
Watching some eagles here on April 1st. Isaac is with us. All the eagles just soaring around looking for some food.
Where'd they go?
Right over the trees. See the
That's hard to do. You can put your hat on your head, Isaac.
There.
Yeah. Put your hat on. Put it on your head. Sure. Say bye-bye. 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 That's right. Tickle your toes.
Hello, Emily. You just lost a hat. April 1st, Ely, Minnesota. Hello, Isaac. Snowbank Lake, Dan Utsi and myself went skiing down this lake and past those islands. Ended up going about a mile out of our way. Got a little lost. Hit me, Dano. Yep. Hey, Isaac. How are you, buddy? Oh, hi.
You're not recording.
Yes. Well, this little shot is for the Jones boys. We want to show you this large
tree with pine cones way at the top. See the pine cones? The pine cones are all over the top of this big old tree. Can you identify this tree? See the spindly spine, the pine needles? Yeah, it's a very tall tree in the pine family. This is another question for the Jones boys. We're looking at another kind of pine tree that is also very tall, as you can see. It goes way up there. But if you look real closely at some of the end pieces, you can see a tiny little knobs on them. Those are the pine cones for this tree. And I'll give you a little hint. These little pine cones are wrapped up real tight. And after a forest fire, these are the type of pine trees that start germinating before all the others. It's the first tree to start. Well, here we are again, Emily and Isaac and Dan. And we're trying to figure out what kind of a pine tree this is. It has much smaller needles and reddish looking things way at the top. And we don't know what they are. Are those pine needles? What are those? What kind of a pine tree is this? A reddish something on the top. Very tiny needles. Here we have a white tree, Gabe and Josh. And see what it has on there on the bark? What kind of bark is that? What kind of a tree is white and has bark like that and grows without any needles? It's not a pine tree, but there's pine trees around it. There's some other white trees right by it that are older. Are those the same kind? It seems to have a little bit different bark, or does it? Very interesting. What is the answer to these trees that have bark that's white and bark that is used to help start fires because it has flammable oil? It also is unwrapped to make canoes and make paper and baskets. Thanks. Gabe and Josh, right here in the middle of these white trees and pine trees is something very unusual. It seems like there's holes in this tree trunk. In fact, the tree has no top. It fell down. What made these holes? Is that human made? Or did an animal make those? Maybe a giraffe? No. What animal made these holes?
A woodpecker? No, it's kind of big.
Hi, Josh and Gabe. Do you notice any mushrooms in this picture? You may want to ask Carl. He can tell you. Because I think if you look real closely, there might be a mushroom growing on this dead tree. How about that? Huh. Wonder what kind of mushroom that is. Well, here we are with another type of pine tree. It's kind of reddish bark. And it has real tall trunk, and the actual pines are the actual needles on it, as you can see, are real tiny. What do you suppose that kind of a pine tree is? It's got red bark, real tall like this, and real small little needles. See that? Having a lunch. Might be good documentation, might be CFS. It's abuse. We have our child captured in a little prison. Made up to look like a backpack. And alas, we force his face against the backing of the prison. Who is the culprit? of this female cry.
Oh.
It's a wilderness woman. There's a man canoeing. All right.
Got fishing equipment on board?
Can't tell. All right. We got to get out and try some canoeing, guys.
Spent a lot of time here this vacation, reading to each other. Isaac has a really fun book, and Aunt Ellie is reading. Emergency vehicles.
Good job. Oh, yay. Isaac did it. Yay. Turn the page. What's this? Turn the page again, and it's the end of the story.
Well, to the Jones boys again. We've got a different kind of pine right here in front of the camera. And this particular pine is very short, as you can see. And its bark kind of has almost like a peely, paper peely siding to it. Now, what is that? If you look at their pines, it's more leafy. It's flat, as you can see, very flat. And I'll give you a hint. This particular pine smells really nice, and a lot of people like to make pieces of furniture out of it, and they like to line their clothing closets and chests out of this. I wonder what kind of pine tree this is.
Here
we are, getting the canoe ready to head out to open water. As you can see, it's on the car. Thank you, John Lehman. We're trying to be very gentle.
Oh, look at them. Oh my goodness. Oh,
as
wow.
You can see.
Get off the road, Lennies.
Oh, look, there's a lot of them. There's some there. Oh, hi, dear. We're not going to hurt you.
There they go.
See, there's one up there. Did you see him? Mm-hmm.
There's one up in the woods. Do you see him?
Yeah, he's right up there.
Get off the road, sweetheart.
Hello, my friend. Oh, he's beautiful. As you can see, we're having a good time out here.
See him coming down from the woods, Em?
Uh-huh. Two of them coming down.
Yeah.
They're telling us to get out of here.
And this one right here is...
You see one right there?
Uh-huh. He's right here by the pole. See?
Oh, there yeah. He is.
Hi. Hi, dear.
Oh, there's another one coming out of the woods, too.
We won't hurt you.
So pretty.
Dude.
Yes, I
see the trail they've already made.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's supposed to be a regular
trail for them, huh?
Mm-hmm.
As you can see, Isaac is all excited, as well as his father.
He got his head down on the
There's the back end of the canoe. We need to get him into the water.
He's his head is up now. You see him?
Okay.
Hi folks, we're in Ely, Minnesota. This is our canoe, and we're about to go canoeing down, what river is this, Daniel?
I forget. Garden Lake.
Garden Lake River.
It's not a river, it's a lake.
Garden Lake, no river. City girl here.
And what we're going to try to do is head over to this bridge and go on down.
Here we are. April 2, Tuesday. Up near Ely, Minnesota, 1997. Eloise Davis and Dan are going to get that canoe out and are going to brave the cold waters. And I'm standing here with Isaac on my back, who's kind of moving around and making me shake a little bit. And we see lots of snow here and some ice on the water, but some people just cannot be stopped. Have to try this kind of early. So that's what they're going to do. Hi, Isaac. Say hi to everybody. So here we go. Yeah, you want to go see what they're doing? Okay, let's go a little closer. It's a Kevlar canoe, fortunately. So it weighs a little over 40 pounds, and Dan can just lift it up. And here come our heroes now.
Natalie and I are going to go into the wilderness.
Say again?
Ellie and I are going into the wilderness.
Wow.
New one.
Hi, big boy.
April 2nd, 1997.
Okay.
Or is it third?
Second.
Okay, the second.
There they go. Careful, guys.
Hi,
Eloise.
Hi.
Are you scared?
A little.
Oh, are you?
She said just a little.
Hi, Emily. Hi, Isaac.
If you pull that canoe back just a little bit, we can watch you get in better. Okay. There goes Miss Eloise. Like an expert. Watch out for alligators. And there they go. There goes Daddy and Eloise, Isaac. How about that? We'll go up on the bridge and watch them. Oh, Isaac is missing them already. Are you missing Daddy and Ellie? Are you? Are you missing them? Say hi, Daddy.